hear correctly, Kiana James saying Roxanne Perez is going to face Asuka. Is the Prodigy ready for the Empress of Tomorrow?
You know what that is, right? Shaggy Daggy Quack Quack moment, man.
Well, what we are ready for is the start of this year's NXT Women's Breakout Tournament.
Please welcome the competitors in the 2023 NXT Women's Breakout Tournament. From Miami, Florida, Lola Vice.
Vice certainly has been heating things up lately. Can she take the next step here in NXT?
Jalula Green.
From Louisville, Kentucky, Danny Palmer.
Has shined in brief moments, but now it's time to see what Palmer is made of.
From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Ariana Grace.
Grace competing again this year after suffering an injury after last year's tournament. Is she ready to finally break out?
From Port St. Lucie, Florida, Jada Parker.
Says she stays 10 steps ahead of the competition. She's going to have to show it in this tournament.
From Albuquerque, New Mexico, Ja'Kara Jackson.
I already know who your pick is, but.
My God, man. She's ready. She's
from
ready.
Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Carmen Petrovich.
Third degree black belt says she doesn't waste time showing mercy on anyone.
And the two women competing in the first match of the tournament. From Boynton Beach, Florida, Kelani Jordan.
Gotta be honest, gotta consider her the favorite.
You know, she is top three for me, Vic.
And from Niles, Michigan, Izzi.
Lives by the motto, you either have it or you don't.
These are your 2023 Women's Breakout Tournament competitors, and the first match starts now!
Booker, you said in your top three, there's only eight women in it, as you can see by the bracket, so you basically have chosen half the field to win in this Breakout Tournament against Jordan.
I said top three,
perhaps. There's only eight women, take one!
I can't do that.
Well, we will see who will be the first one to advance in this year's Women's Breakout Tournament. And of course, I gotta go back. Asuka coming here against Roxanne Perez, possibly next week if that gets made official. Asuka could be the WWE Women's Champion if she's victorious Saturday at Fastlane.
It's gonna be a step-up moment for Roxanne Perez. I'm gonna tell you, I believe it, but it's gonna be a hell of a, hell of a match.
We're going to see who will be the first to step up in this tournament, because Izzi Dame in control. Physical toughness is what could separate her from the rest of the field, as there you see Kelani Jordan, who again, the former Michigan State Spartan, certainly has had some, well, she's kind of battle-tested to some degrees compared to the other competitors.
I see something in Jordan. She's on that fast track, trying to make it to that next level. She's got a lot of talent, I mean, balance, grace, all of that, but right now she's into it.
Well, just got caught with a slide down, trying to get Izzi down as well. And just too powerful, too strong is the former professional volleyball player. Played D1 at Eastern Michigan.
I don't know a lot about Izzi Dame, but she's got a lot of muscle, a lot of strength. That right there's going to work in her advantage against Kelani Jordan here tonight.
Take a look at this. Wait a minute, first victory could be seconds away. Jordan able to kick out. What are you looking for in this tournament from some like Izzi, who's making their NXT debut?
Now, let me tell you something. Izzi got to understand, this time on television is worth its weight in gold. You got to show the upper echelon. I'm talking about the producers. I'm talking about the scouts. You got to show them something here tonight, Vic.
These two setting the tone for the tournament. Is there an advantage, though, Booker, for these two being in the first match, able to get out those maybe jitters, those butterflies?
You know, the adrenaline factor in a matchup like this, I'm sure the butterflies is all over the place, going to get those butterflies to line up and fly straight, but I don't think there's any advantages, Vic. I think the nerves is running through both of these young ladies.
NXT Universe shot fire with Jordan. Nice backbreaker.
This spot is damn victory.
Dame sort of talked some trash, and that was a unique Move somewhat. Offense jumping on the bottom rope across the throat and was almost able to pick up the victory as Dame now in control, as there you see the watch party for this breakout tournament. The six remaining competitors are in, watching in the front row. All eyes on this matchup. All eyes on who will be the first superstar to advance. And you just think about how big this tournament could be for the eight women involved.
But let's talk about the two right here in the middle of this ring. Izzi, Dame, I always look for the playbook. See if you're thinking about, you know, that game plan, that strategizing. And Izzi right now is looking good.
Tiffany Stratton was in the finals last year, of course, won the NXT Women's title this year. Ooh, right across the throw. That's what I was talking about. Some of this impressive offense, unique style by Dame. We talk about Stratton, who also main evented No Mercy. Talk about Roxanne Perez, who was the winner last year. Went on to also win the Iron Survivor last year, the revolutionary Iron Survivor match, of course, part of NXT Deadline, our next premium live event, Saturday, December the 9th. But right now, Jordan just trying to make it to the next round, being bent in half. Dame looking for the submission, looking to advance. And right now, what is your first impression of Izzi Dame?
Right now, Izzi is ripping Kelani like a red dog. This thing is not going to last much longer, Fitch.
Jordan trying to fight her way free, able to roll down, shoulders down one more time. Whoa. Referee, great position with Dame, able just to kick out. And you talk about a bracket buster for sure. This would have to be considered one, because as I've mentioned to most, Kelani Jordan is the odds-on favorite. Has to be in the top two for some, unlike Booker, who took half the field to win. And a nice counter, nice takedown in Jordan. Starting to feel it, and this goes
beautiful
back.
Beautiful drop kick, beautiful Vic.
This goes back to Kelani Jordan having been battle-tested, having been in the deep waters previously.
You know, having that television time definitely going to do Kelani a lot of good, but Vic, these ladies are young. I mean, an uptick can happen at a moment's notice at this level.
High cross body from the top.
Oh, man.
Just able to power out, and maybe going back to your point of the power advantage for Izzi Dame coming through as she was able to kick out, but a nice counter. Dame coming right back in and just planted Jordan. Jordan could be out, into the cover, to advance, and another near
fall. These ladies are taking it to the limit right now. Let you know how much this tournament really, really means. Talking about that meteoric rise of Roxanne Perez. Who's next? Who's next, Vic?
We also talk about Stratton Perez. You also look at superstars like Fallon Henley, who all came through Kiana James, the breakout tournament a year ago. And now for Kelani Jordan. Uh-oh, in the drop zone. Split leg. Got her with the moonsault. Into the cover. Jordan, the first to advance.
Wow.
We talk about the butterflies, we talk about the advantage of being the first match. We saw the watch party, everyone looking on, everyone in the NXT universe saw what both these women were made of. And for Izzi Dame, she was close in this matchup to having an upset. But Kelani Jordan, able to battle through, hit this split-legged moonsault, connected perfectly. And you know what? She also had the presence of mind to realize where Dame was at in the ring at that moment and capitalize as Jordan becomes the first superstar to advance in the breakout tournament. Congratulations to Kelani Jordan.